Hello to you from ChemHelp ASAP. In simple systems, coupling patterns can be readily predicted through a mathematical relationship called Pascal's triangle. In the middle of the screen, we have a pattern called Pascal's triangle. The top of the triangle and the sides have the number 1. The values inside the triangle are determined by adding the two adjacent numbers that are above the value. So above the 2 are 2 1s. 1 plus 1 is 2. Above the 3 is a 1 and 2. 1 plus 2 is 3, and so forth. This pattern of numbers allows quick prediction of coupling patterns in proton spectra. To the left is a set of numbers, 0 through 4. These numbers represent the number of neighboring hydrogens, vicinal neighbors that a hydrogen has. We'll call this column N, number of neighbors. So if a hydrogen has 0 neighbors, the signal for that hydrogen will have a single peak, a singlet. If a hydrogen has 1 neighbor, the signal for that hydrogen will have 2 peaks with a relative intensity of 1 to 1, a doublet. 2 neighbors, the signal will be 3 peaks with a relative intensity of 1 to 2 to 2 to 1, a triplet. 3 neighbors, a quartet. 5 neighbors, a pentet. The number of peaks in the signal is 1 larger than the number of neighbors. This relationship is sometimes called the N plus 1 rule. What isn't obvious from Pascal's triangle is that the split peaks become less intense than the original peak. So for a doublet, the relative intensity of the peaks in the doublet is 1 to 1, but each peak in the doublet is half the intensity of the original singlet. The triplet with a 1 to 2 to 1 relative intensity has an actual intensity of 0.25, 0.50, 0.25. So the total intensity is still just 1. Let's see some examples. Here is a hypothetical case. We have 2 hydrogens. Let's focus on the right hydrogen, and it has 1 neighbor, the left hydrogen. So the right hydrogen generates a signal. That signal appears at a certain chemical shift. The neighbor splits the intensity of 1, into 2 signals, each with an equal intensity of 0.5. The multiplicity is the number of neighbors plus 1, a doublet. The total intensity of the doublet, the integration, is 1 because the signal is arising from just 1 hydrogen. This signal is a 1H doublet. Here is another hypothetical case. Let's again focus on the right hydrogen, and it now has 2 neighbors, the left hydrogens. Let's say one is red and the other is blue. The right hydrogen generates a signal at a certain chemical shift. The red neighbor splits the signal, intensity of 1, into 2 signals, each with an intensity of 0.5. The blue neighbor continues the pattern by splitting the two 0.5 intensity signals. This second splitting technically gives 4 signals of intensity 0.25. 2 of these signals overlap. So you only see 3 peaks, a triplet, with a middle of the triplet having double intensity from the overlap. The total intensity of all the peaks in the triplet is 1.0. That's the integration, 1 hydrogen, a 1H triplet. Let's now look at the 2 hydrogens on the left, red and blue. Both of these hydrogens will generate a signal at the same chemical shift. The red hydrogen will be split by the neighbor on the right into two signals, each with an intensity of 0.5. The blue hydrogen will be split by the neighbor on the right into two signals. Each has an intensity of 0.5. The split signals will overlap with each other to give rise to a collective doublet, two peaks. The total intensity of the doublet will be 2. This is a 2H doublet. We have demonstrated how the mathematical pattern of Pascal's triangle can help predict a peak's multiplicity. If you like this video, please leave a like and or subscribe. Leave any questions, comments, or feedback in the comments section. Take care.